Welcome back, viewers, to another episode of This Is Persia in Europa Universalis 4. I just had an idea. Muscovy, you have no friends. That's interesting. Great Horde, you are pretty weak. That's interesting as well. Uzbeks, they are irrelevant. Yosuni, that's interesting. So here's my thoughts. What if we do a quick, sneaky war against the Great Horde? We vassalize him. Okay, we won't be able to get alliance with Spain if we want to do that. But I don't think the alliance with Spain is... It'll be potentially handy, but... Here's my thoughts, right? We vassalize a Great Horde. And we do a reconquest against Muscovy. I mean, look at all of their land. And the nice thing about reconquest is that it generates very little aggressive expansion. Which means we can take all of this land in one war. And here's another interesting thing I thought about as well. Because they're Sunni, we can force them to become Shia as part of the peace deal. So we can vassalize them, force them to become Shia, and then reconquest all of this, and they will convert all of that to Shia for us. So I think we might do that actually, rather than spending more time going south or something. I mean, we do need to go attack the Mamluks in, what's this, 5 years' time. That's fine. You've actually ditched your alliance with Dokadir. Dokadir is now allied to nobody. That's funny. And slightly unexpected. Ally with Wasangali. Wasangali is... Okay, some ram tiny nation in the Horn of Africa. So they are irrelevant. So let's finish this war first. And I think afterwards, I'm going to swing around, attack you and attack Muscovy while we have two techs ahead of him in military. Crazy? Maybe. But I kind of want to also prove a point about why I don't understand why AI doesn't do better as hordes, because I'm going to go kick Muscovy's ass. All of this land down here is steppe, which is excellent for us. And I guess, I don't know, once we do that with the Great Horde, we can actually try to be really sneaky and, I mean, we can possibly even release like Kazan or something, because Kazan also have a lot of cores here we can do a reconquest war against. The Shinovgrad is too far north now. So yeah, that's an interesting idea, but I don't know. I mean, it does mean we'll be expanding northwards, which doesn't really help us too much. But it's an idea. For now, we have engaged the enemy in Istria. Of course we have. Question of rights. A subject of ours currently holds lands to which we have a claim. Okay. Najda. Which is it? Dumyat. Yeah, that's fine. Renounce the claimant for. Yes, of course, that's a claim. Oh, well, that's interesting. Let's actually have a leader here. Oh, wow, what the hell? My Shahanshah is 59 and Shahanzad is 54. That's not going to be good. This is not great. Because what's going to happen is when you die, you'll probably die straight afterwards or vice versa. Fortunately for us, we are not a Christian nation, which means we can't fall under personal union like what Lithuania happened with Poland, but that's interesting. And not that good either. If you were like, I don't know, 20, that'd be amazing, because you actually have very good monarch points. That's unfortunate. I was about to possibly make one of them into a leader, but let's not do that. Can we get a free leader anytime soon? Contribute warriors. Do we need more? Not really, so let's not do that. Raise hosts, it can be done 55. Okay. Okay, where are my leaders then? Where the heck are my generals? What, do I have two generals here? No, I only have one general, where's my other general? Oh, okay. Huh. Well, in that case, what's to do as generalists? That's fine. Cause of battle against Naj is gone, that's fine as well. They are sending more troops around this way. This is not a great fight for us. Oh, okay, we need a leader here. Okay, so I am going to dump all of these. And have you go somewhere, doesn't really matter where. Where are you going? You're going north. Okay, in that case, we don't need a leader here. But it'll still be good to have a leader here, because they seem to constantly attack Istria for some reason. we have rebellions. Omanian rebellions. Crimean rebellion. Oh my god, what the hell? That looks pretty bad. Where is my 21 stack? Over here. Where are the knights gone? Okay, well, half of you go down here. Half of you go up here so we can go attack Great Horde. And also we need to deal with the Crimean rebels, which number in the 23,000. Never mind. Both of you go up here. I'm going to have to turn this fort on. These knights are ridiculous, but looks like they're leaving. Or maybe they're not. Freaking knights. Okay, let's continue this. This is silly. Yep, they're going. The sieging was this. Erisimdra? Eriskadrava. Okay, sure. Something happened in Africa as well. Sure. I'm gonna have to send something down this way. Coast being raided. You. Go away. You. Come here. Let's minimize attrition, so put you guys there. This is only level 2 fort, so I'll send 2k there. These two are still not falling yet, which is kind of annoying. Oh, that one needs more people. That's also annoying. Oh, you can't get there anymore. Hmm, interesting. Come back from France. And we need military access from Munster. We had before. Okay, some siege is over. Dobrovnik. Okay, can I piece you out separately? No, I cannot. These are all vassals. Okay, you are going to go here and deal with the knights because they are a thorn in my side. Siege of Ruska is over. Cool, I can piece out Ruska separately when my diplomat comes back home. Okay, well, all of you. I'm going to send most of you. You guys go here. As for the rest, we have Hungary is not attached to you anymore. Huh. Okay, that's actually fine. Hungary is doing their own thing now. Okay, fair enough. It's about freaking time Hungary does something on their own without my hand holding. Man is still stuck on the island. Siege of Gare is over. Excellent. Hey, Gare, give me all your money. Now, what else can I do with you? I mean, I could, like, vassalize you, but that's gonna piss off a lot of people. Not worthwhile. Just give me a trade. Give me a war reps. Give me your money. And. See if Ruska wants peace. In a second. Give me a second. Give me 1 second. What can I do with all this extra prestige? I don't see anything I can really use this prestige for. Because I don't have any subjects, I can't just up prestige to them like you normally can. But that's okay. High prestige is fine. So, all your money, war reps, and I actually don't care about anything else. Just have a quick look. Military access, don't really care about any of those. Rivals, don't care. Alliances with Denmark and East Frisia, irrelevant. Go away, Gary. How is our inflation looking? We've lost trade dispute. Okay. Let's send you over here. Oh, you're black flagged now. But why aren't you black flagged? That's not great. So to un-black flag, I have to go all the way back here, do I? That's annoying. Hungary, aren't you going to go, like, relieve your own siege? Oh, Hungary. It's almost like you're stupid or something. Sometimes the AI does act a little bit stupid. It's a thing. Well, I actually need an army if I want to take that on. And these knights as well, it's so annoying. They haven't sieged anything down yet, which is hilarious in itself. You guys, House of Crimean Prince looking? 90% now. That's okay, we're nearly there. Defend of the Faith, City of Ruska. Ruska, give me your money. What are you, by the way? Ruska, you are Republic. That's kind of cool. Well, you don't have much money to begin with. I can force you to become my vassal. Not that many people actually care. It is a tempting thing. Like, I could do this just so I can have one vassal I can feed all this land down here to. Like a question. Is there a common core here? I can release Ottomans here and as a vassal. Wouldn't that be funny? But no, that'd be dumb. Because if I release Ottomans, I also release Ottomans from all of these places too. So I can't actually do that. That's kind of funny though. I can't tell them to release the Ottomans. Who is... Oh man, Byzantine cores over here. So I can't release Byzantine. Or Byzantium. Serbia. Serbia was a thing once upon a time. I could release Serbia here. But no, if I want to do this plan with the Great Horde, I need to leave my diplomat slots open. So let's not even think about that. Ruska, just go away. I don't want you. I've rejected you. Give up all claims to Bosnia. No, you can keep those claims. You can keep the arrival as well. I don't care. Okay, so yeah, Ruska accepted our generous peace offer, which only involves all his money. Crimean separatists are fired. Let's go kill them. Oh, that's annoying. Huh. Well, hope we can get it fast enough. Let's put you in charge. Gain diplomatic insult against Gujarat. Gujarat. Whatever. You guys. Come on, let's go kill these stupid nice down ISO. And, okay, you're coming back here. Still black flagged. Okay, go here then. And for some reason, you're not black flag, which is very dangerous because you're one stack. I don't like this. I don't understand why you were black flag, but you weren't. That makes no sense. Oh, why do I have so many troops here? Hungary, what are you doing? Hungary, okay. Idiot Hungary. Okay, Hungary, I'm gonna hold your hand and go relieve the siege of your own fort. Okay. Core, and more cores. Awesome. This should be an easy win. Bohemia declare war on the planet. Bohemia are still Catholic. That is very odd. Because usually Bohemia is one of the first nations to go Protestant. And usually they're the ones who lead the Protestant League. Ooh, nope, we don't want that. This 8k is still black flagged, which is lovely. Okay, Battle of Kurzoya. Cool. The House of Karakunlu is shaken. There seems to be a misunderstanding regarding the heritage of the great-grandmother of Jahan Shah I. It seems she was the daughter of a lowly farmer from outside Constantinople. That seems unlikely considering we only conquered Constantinople less than like... considering lifespans back then were much shorter, so yeah, I guess it's possible. Well, we just deny it or we lose prestige. Neither demand too much. I guess I'd much rather have high horde unity, so let's just lose some prestige. Besides, prestige is cheap. You guys, come here, we're about to go declare war on Great Horde, and then I'll see if I can get some friends in to help fight against Muscovy as well, but if not, that's okay. Alternatively, I can declare war on Lithuania because Lithuania also owns some cores that's owned by the Great Horde as well. I think it's a good idea. Okay, you'll be there on 29th. 30th, this could be problematic actually, 31st. Okay, Vance won't get there until the 31st. That's kind of important because if I arrive there first, I'll get stack wiped, I think. Maybe. Oh, Menace, what are you doing? Menace, go help out your... Okay, or don't. Conversion complete. Sweet. There's plenty more to convert. Chios, Mantriga, and Theodoro. Menace probably does not want to be in this war for much longer. We're back to sieging this, but it's going to take a long time. I don't actually care about separate piecing Oldenburg that much. Who's attacking you? Venice. Okay. Well, we'll swing right back around. You are heading to Smolgi. We're on a siege in Dalmatia. Okay, fair enough. We can't stack wipe you because you ran away. That's fine. You're going to Bux. Okay, nice and easy. Now let's go down here. You are heading to Sopron. 23rd, 24th, 21st. Shit. We'll be fighting for a day by ourselves. Okay, fine. whatever. We should still win it. I'd be amazed if we don't. They are moving away. You go up this way. Those knights. Oh man. I have to constantly pay attention to the knights, otherwise they just run away. Which basically means they always run away. Okay, I know I'm going to kill one. You. Uzbeks won't answer the quest. Excellent. Tribal feud. Ha. Huh. Nah, it's Clensing of Heresy. Simple. Oh wow, these Hungarian troops are terrible. This should be an easy stack while with my own troops. Come on, Hungary. Thank you. Seriously, that should be an easy stack one. We outnumber them significantly there. We actually lost a lot more. Actually, did we? No, we didn't. We killed much more, but still. That was terrible. Okay, what's happening here? You're running away to one tower away. Cool. How many of you are left? Could be a concern. 23rd. Okay, should be fine. And you go up as well. Let's be extra sure. Awesome. Fortune siege. Let's do a minimal siege. Which just means 4k. The rest of you come here. Can we repay our loans? We probably can. Let's do it. And we'll earn even more money before the end. Get your enemy in Vassarid. Siege of Istria is over. We lost a... Oh, you gotta be kidding me. You got stack wiped? That's bullshit. They should have arrived together, but apparently they didn't. Okay, so I just lost like a horse and infantry. Yeah, that's a problem leading around AI like that. Hungary? I don't know, man. You're supposed to be my ally, but... You're actually causing me a lot of pain here. I mean, it wasn't that much pain, but still. It was avoidable pain. Okay, we now have 75% war score. Is there anyone else we can peace out? I don't think there is. Luca would be too much of a pain to get to. Okay, let's see if we can do our peace deal now. Also, this. Give it back to me. Nudged. So, give me all of this. How's it look? The knights don't care. Poland. That's a little scary. But I think we can handle Poland. In fact, no one here is potentially dangerous. Except Poland. Poland's the only dangerous one. And Poland will be slightly upset if I go ham on Muscovy. Or will he? I mean, Poland doesn't actually like Muscovy. They hate Muscovy, in fact. So, it might just work out. Yep, let's do this. I think it'll be fine. Muscovy won't be joining the coalition, which means we can just attack right into Muscovy straight afterwards. So, let's do this. Peace deal. And the more important thing is Spain won't do this. In fact, Spain? Will you be my friend? You totally would, except you're not going to because I'm going to make you really hate me from doing this. Which is not great, but whatever, give me some money. Wow, you're actually really poor. What else can I do to you? I can possibly not take all your money. I can't humiliate, it costs 40%. I thought it only cost 30%. Never mind. In that case, give me all of this. Give me war reps. Okay, don't give me war reps then, give me all your money. Okay, so a little bit of war score left. What else can I do? Also, I need to check overextension. Do I have any issues with overextension? Ooh, you want me to conquer Kerman. Kerman's over here. I will take that under consideration. We have admin points to get the next level innovative if we wanted to. Not that important. Okay, is there anything I can possibly do with you? I don't want to spend double points if I can help it. Military access. I don't actually want to cancel your subjects. Besides, your subject will probably rebel without my help right now. In fact, with this setup here, I think all these subjects will rebel. And when they do, I'll just attack all your subjects individually. As each of them do. Although, I won't have a choose time with them, so that kind of sucks. Okay, how about this? Revoke cause. I don't need it, though, except for prestige. But I don't need a prestige. I might as well keep the choose time shorter. So give me your money, give me this land here, and go away. Major victory, second Karakundu Jihad against Venice. Venice will cede Valona, Macedonia, Skopje, Negroponte, Durazo and Skirtari to Karakun. Pay 147 ducats and allies. I get 89 ducats. Oh wow, so apparently Hungary actually contributed a decent amount to this war, which is a little surprising considering they didn't really do a hell lot. Okay, Hungary gets 13 power projection, we gain 13. They lose 27. Not as much as I would like, but that's okay. Lost a trade dispute against Cyprus, the Nice, Oldenburg, and Lucca. We lost a military rival. That's fine. Muscovy. Okay, we have no diplomats. Spain does not like us anymore. What a real shame. That's okay. We'll let the aggressive expansion decay a little bit in Europe while we focus on Asia and Eastern Europe. By Europe, I mean Central and Western Europe. Of course, Western Europe doesn't even care that we exist right now, like France. Do you even care that I exist? That I just took a whole bunch of land? Eh, look, but you're taking notice. Spain does, but that's only because they have Spanish Italy. Great Britain probably doesn't even care. Yeah, -3 aggressive expansion. They don't care at all. If you look up here, Austria. -31. Yeah, it's getting there. Hungary. 0. Oh, that's interesting. So if you pull your ally into a war with you and you take a... Oh, never mind. Aggressive expansion, -56. So yeah, they got aggressive expansion as well. That's okay. So we got all of this. You boy will be annoying because it's an island. And the only way you can get to it is through Athens. Because it's got a strait between Athens and itself. Hopefully it doesn't rebel. Did I ever turn this into a state? I don't think I did. I can't give any of this to a tribes. Does tribe want more land? That's a, probably a good question as well. The tribes. Not subjects, estates. They don't. Well, first, let's burn everything down as I do. Can't burn Thessaly. Macedonia, let's burn Macedonia down. Skopje. Costria. Oh, can't burn that down. Because I already have. And it's Gord and Shia. Valor. Oh, what's this? Sturis. Lazzy. Anything else I can burn down? Zeta is... Montenegrin. Okay, and anything else I can take? I mean, I can burn? Nope, there is not. Well, let's call all of this. 68% overextension. And all of you, head this way. Hero from Bavaria, declare war on Salzburg. That's nice. Poland. Yeah, Poland could be problematic. We'll see though, I mean we do have Austria and Hungary as allies, and is that it? I mean we have 4 diplo slots, if those 2 allies, what else are we using our diplo slots for? Leading vassal, wait, what? City of Raska is my vassal? Did I accidentally vassalize you? Whoops, I must have accidentally vassalized you. No, I don't want City of Raska. When did I vassalize you? It must have been a peace deal. I was playing around with the idea of vassalization and... I don't want City of Raska. Well, that's very annoying. Does anyone else want City of Raska? I wanted to just ditch this. I don't want this as a vassal. Damn it, that gave me a great advantage for no reason. I didn't even notice. Oh, shit. That's not good. That's not good. That's not good. Huh. Yeah, I think if I... It must have been on my peace deals somewhere. I think if I didn't vassalize City of Raska, that would have been at least a decent chunk of expansion I would not have incurred. Okay, I guess we're not going to do anything crazy in Europe right now. Which probably means I'm not going to attack Muscovy. Which means against Great Horde... Even though it's a great idea, I think it's not a good idea to get involved in the War of Muscovy right now, because all it's going to do is make me look weak when I start losing troops. Which I think it shouldn't be too hard of a war, but even then, I don't think it's worth it. And besides, I can always do this at a later date. It's not important right now. Muscovy is going to stay lagging behind. Poland and Lithuania will not. In fact, they're already caught up. Poland is really catching up. As far as... what do you call this? Institutions go. Yep, they've embraced it. And it's spreading to Lithuania. Which means it could be at least another 20 years before it's spread to Muscovy. At a minimum. Because I think Muscovy hates everyone here. Muscovy hates Sweden. Muscovy hates Lithuania. Muscovy, I hate Muscovy, and yeah, so basically Muscovy is not going to get colonialism from me at all, or from Lithuania, or from Sweden, so they are going to be lagging behind tech the longer we wait. So I think let's ignore Muscovy for now. I will still take Great Horde as a vassal because we got a lot of double points. But yeah, that was not what I expected. I didn't expect an extra vassal in the form of, say, a Ruska. That was just weird and unusual. We're not going to declare on Bosnia, even though we totally could. Yeah, we need to wait for this extra expansion to die down a little bit. And we have to make sure we attack Mamluks on schedule. That's very important. But since we have so many stuff now, so much stuff now, I might start integrating Najd. I think it would be a good idea. So, Najd, whatever. Oh, I can't do it yet. Okay, the moment this war's over then. Spain declared war on Lunda. That's fine. Shame too, I was hoping Spain could be my ally. They're outraged. That's not good. Let's bring you back. Let's try to improve with Bosnia. I'm going to try and improve with... Pope Man doesn't hate me. Bohemia. Griff expansion is getting there. How long is our truce timer? I actually wanted a longer truce timer, to be honest, just so for aggressive expansion to die down. Revanchism, because they lost pretty badly. Truce timers. 61. So that's 12 years. So we're going to have 12 years without aggressive expansion to take down. So that means 12 times 2.5, we're looking at, what, 25, 20, 30? 30. Okay, yeah, I think we'll be ready to go to war against Venice again. Genoa, I don't care too much about. I don't have to attack Genoa. Although that said, if I attack Genoa, Papal State's going to be nasty, because I want this land here. But, I mean, I still want Venetian lands more than I want the Pope land. I think I'm not going to attack Genoa on schedule, even though I probably could. Huge... truce timer here as well, and you hate my guts. But minus 30, you're probably still drawing a coalition against me. So maybe I do have to attack Genoa on schedule as well, just to make sure they don't join a coalition. I mean, for all I know, coalition might actually fire, because Poland plus Spain is a lot. And the fact is, we also have a coalition on this front here with Korsun. Korsun is not strong per se, but it's gonna be really annoying, and Nogai as well. Because that means we're going to have to fight on two fronts. Which means our forces will be heavily divided. That said, Austria-Hungary will be here to help out on the Western Front. Which means our Eastern Front will be pretty easily dealt with. So I don't know. If the coalition fires, so be it. I think. I really messed up there. I didn't expect Spain to join. At all. That was not part of the plan. I didn't expect you to become a vassal. I still don't get how that happened. That was really weird. Unless... No, I still have peace with Ruska, so yeah, I had to have accidentally vassalized you. And stupid, because I can't actually cancel vassalization until our truce is over. Like if I hover over this, break vassalization. Yeah, you can't cancel vassalization when it's enforced by a truce, which is not for another long, long time. 57, that's 8 more years. I don't want you, damn it. I'm going to keep you as Catholic though, because if I change you to... Shia, what's gonna happen is you're just gonna hate my guts more so than you really do. Which, surprisingly, you don't hate you that much. Funny. Where are my forces? Also, how's Revenge looking? Omani, Theodoran. Okay, so I need you guys to go here, take care of the Theodoran rebels. Cretan over in Chios. Okay, I'm gonna need an army down here. Mamlukian. Also, I do need to help Oman, to help Najd, because... Oh, speak of Najd, Oman. 52, so 3 years. We have to go to war here in 3 years, go to war here in 4 years. Okay, so I'm going to have to spread my forces out a little bit. 14k will stay here. Cretan. Cretan, okay, so we need 15k here. Okay, so what am I doing? You go down here, you will help patrol this area. You will need to go down there. Who else do we have? Theodoro is 15k, that'll be handled up there. Mamlukian and Omani. For some reason, they haven't fired yet, but I do need help out over there, so you are going to go over here. And part of this is also preparation for attacking Oman. I think we're going to just chill out for a little bit, because we have a lot of aggressive expansion with a lot of people. I do want to attack Bermanis at some point. They have no allies, and I want to get all this land down here so we can get another merchant for free. We're losing 5 lakhs a month. Great! I like losing money. It's fun. My favorite pastime, even. Hey, Austria. You have an army, right? Oh, wow. Austria has one hell of an army. How are you not suffering attrition here? What is the force limit on this tile? Someone tell me. Force limit here is 48. Wow. I mean, it's not force limit, supply limit. That's insane. That is incredible. 48 at this point in the game. Okay, well, like I said, Austria has a huge army. So that's going to be very helpful. France, let's just try to improve a few random people. Let's make sure France doesn't hate me too much. I may as well make sure Chu doesn't hate me too much. And again, Ruska. Mistake. Should not have happened. Oh man, this is still going up, isn't it? Sort of. I can't wait to get up to here. Where is it? Optimism. It'll be so amazing once we do. An idea. Should I get an idea or get this? 8 plus years. We really badly need more admin power, so there's another reason to take on some vassals, I guess. I mean, the War of the Mamluks next, I'll be giving all, and Oman as well, all of it will be given to Najd. I don't want any of it. Arnthold has declared war on Cologne. Okay. Gain trade dispute against Corson. Really? Okay. What are these? Caravels. They're doing nothing. Protect trade. In either Hormuz or Basra or Indus. Send to Basra. According to it, I'll get 1.25 extra ducats, which is a total lie, but whatever. You guys take trade over in... We actually control a lot of Crimea node now, so I actually want to have a merchant up here. What are my merchants doing? And also, I lost a merchant because I reduced... what's it called? I think I lost a merchant here, didn't I? Because I reduced the autonomy, which sucks. And I'm barely losing any autonomy right now, thanks to constant wars. Another reason why I need to conquer more of this region. Well, merchants. Alexandria, that's important. Aleppo, that's important. Indus, that's important. But I also need someone in Crimea. We could make so much more money. Okay, I'm going to take the guy in Indus because... No, I am not. Aleppo. A lot of people are transferring power down this way already, so I'm going to take the guy in Aleppo and send him here. So let's see. We're currently making 22.98. Wow, we make more money from trade than anything else combined. Transfer. Take the guy from Aleppo. 22.98. Let's see how much we get now. Which will be there in 7 days. 22.98. So remember that. Whatever. Oh, that's over. That's good. Come back here. Some improvement in Bosnia. Fortune, declare war on High Sea. Sue for peace. Give me that. No, actually, don't give me that. Vassal, will this force me into a stupid war? Hope not. Become a vassal. No, will not. Cool. And force religion, and give me your money, and do not revoke any cause, because we're going to be using them. Karakum, purge of the Great Horde heresy. I imagine this is what it says. Sue for peace. Kingdom of Heresy is gone. You do not like me. Fair enough. Stop improving in Tunis. Come home. Let's try and improve with you. Now, question. How long will it take to integrate you, as it is? 78. So let's start integrating you now. And next, I need to improve with you. And I need to improve with City of Ruska as well. since we have a stupid vassal, I want to get rid of him as soon as possible. So let's get you back from France. With a little bit of money again. The Great Horde. How pathetic. How do you feel about Muscovy? I imagine you hate Muscovy, which would be good. I need you to hate Muscovy. Okay, diplomat is free. Let's improve the Great Horde. What are these ships? Barks. Go and protect trade over at Crimea. Or Aleppo apparently will give me a lot of money. Now, go to Crimea. And apparently, protect Aleppo. Now, let's go protect Aleppo. So, where are you? Protect trade. Go to Aleppo. And I'll see if I can send you some reinforcements. So, caravels. Let's build 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's build more. 7. Okay, let's double check on this. Omani separatists over here are no more for some reason. Okay. No, that was. Yes, Omani separatists. Theodoran is still a real thing. Theodoran. Okay, so I need to have this 16k stack sit here for a while. Next is Cretan, which is down here. 10k against 15k. It's coastline, which is flat land. Go sit here. That'll be fine. Next is Mamlukian, 13k. And Trebizondi, 11k. Well, you don't need it there anymore, so you come here and merge with this army. Merge. Okay, Magdeburg accepted peace with the planet. Okay, sure. And for now, just peace for a little while. Oh man, that's lots of money. We are calling everything. Yes, we are. Just making sure. Letting war children tick down a little bit, letting autonomy tick down a little bit, and letting, most importantly, aggressive expansion tick down a little bit. I mean, yes, we can go crazy in India right now if we wanted to. We should still be like 2 techs ahead against everyone. 3 techs against Barmanas, even. Oh man, so tempting. But no, let's just let everything tick down a little bit. Verdun, end of religious turmoil. Okay. Chios is converted. Excellent. Vert Kaffa. Afterwards, we only have apparently 1 place to convert. Surprising. Okay. Is all of this Sunni already? I mean, not Sunni, Shia already? No, it's not. Okay, I guess we're still waiting for this. Theodora's converted. Awesome. This is good. Growth of printing industry. That's unfortunate, but okay. Theodoran rebellion has risen. That's fine. The ability to mass produce the written word would revolutionize the spread of information in many ways. The early modern society as a whole, pioneered by Renaissance men such as Venetian printer Aldus Manutius, the new art helped fuel the Renaissance by making the translated classics more widely available. Later, the Reformation benefited greatly from the ability to spread critical publications and the translation of the Holy Scriptures. Now that the printing has matured as a technique and spread throughout Europe, editions have grown and hundreds of thousands of copies of everything from religious and political pamphlets to instructions in how to behave or scientific treatises are circulating the continent. With print shops growing ever more commonplace, rulers have found it hard to contain the new technique as a comparatively easy means of production means censorship can be sidestepped by moving business across a border or even changing the name on the title page. Now the curious thing about this is that this article or this, I don't know, let's say article, okay? This article is speaking of the printing press as if it's really spread, but it's popping up before the printing press has spread. That I find rather interesting. But yeah, this changes everything. Or nothing for now. I am going to have to try and get printing press from Hungary and Austria, and they'll be getting it from somewhere in Europe. Let's actually see, where does it spawn? Printing press spawned in Austria? I thought printing press can only spawn in a Protestant country. What the hell is it doing in Austria? Well, you know, that's a good thing. That's a very good thing. Whoops, I keep getting the wrong thing. Constantinople is getting some printing press embracement, 0.10 per month, but we're going to get a decent natural spread coming from Austria into Hungary, into our lands, because we directly border Hungary, which means we can probably embrace it in like 20 years without any development whatsoever. And I think that's the route I'm going to take, rather than spending another 2,000 monarch points just trying to embrace it, like I've been doing for everything else. And after the printing press, we don't actually have to spend that much monarch points on any other institution, so this is good. I'm glad it's born in Austria rather than all the way up in, say, I don't know, Denmark, or, I don't know, Friesland or Great Britain. That could happen. Oh, 9k here. It's funny that I'm finding armies in random places. How's my force number looking? 115. If I wished. If I could. If I could afford it. Okay, that's fine. Awesome. That battle is over. Next, Cretan. Yep, I know Cretan. Mamlukian, so let's send you down to Mamlukian lands. You are still going that way. What next? Trebizond in Kaffa. Kaffa. Oh, really? Trebizond? Trebizond? Why would I be in Trebizond separatists here? Okay, you have to stay here then. Sorry. You're going there. This 14k I left here because I know that these places will 100% rebel. Oh, speaking of which, forts. I'm keeping this one in Adern. I will remove the one in Macedonia. And keep the one in Lezzy. And yeah, disable the forts for now. I mean, yeah, right now, if the AI wants to take advantage of me, they could attack. But let's be realistic. I have Hungary in the way. Poland is going to have a hell of a time trying to attack me. And if they were to attack me, they'll be attacking from this direction. Not from here. And if they do try to attack from here, guess what? Austria and Hungary will wreck their asses. I'm pretty sure Poland is powerful, but not that powerful, that they can take on both Austria and Hungary together. I mean, to be fair, if you look at sheer size, they're bigger. But to be fair, Muscovy is bigger than both of them added together, and yet Muscovy lost in a war against the two. So, you know. Okay, I'm also against Sweden as well, so yeah. Size isn't everything. It's how you use that size. Okay, this army is just, okay, like I said, just patrolling around here for now. Chilling out. Our income is negative 6 now. I'm not sure what to do about that, really. It's so hard trying to make money. We can embrace new tech. I think I will. Before this gets really expensive. Can we change our government type by any chance? Of course not. We are a horde. What am I saying? Of course we cannot. Korean Temperance is about to fire. Very soon. Is this a bear general? No, it's not. Let's put bear general in charge. The knights have been raiding us. Again. I mean, yeah, I want to kill the knights, but right now they're both a pain to kill. We actually need a proper navy to kill them. The one thing we don't have is a proper navy. By the way, just turn this fort off as well. Is there another fort we need to turn off? Nope, there is not. Using 3.5 ducats in a month now. What are these ships doing? They're protecting Basra. Is there anything better you can do to protect Basra? Alexandria, 1.38. Yeah, I guess I could go protect Alexandria instead. And I guess you'll just be patrolling around here rather than going around the Horn of Africa, which you can't even see. I mean, the Cape of Africa, sorry. Yeah, let's go to Alexandria. Oh, by the way, I never checked. How much money are we making on trade now? 20. So we're actually making less money by doing that. So, in that case, transfer, Crimea, and we'll see it in a new month. This will take at least 20 or 30 years to integrate, which is fine, because we're going to feed you even more before you're done integrating. Bohemia accepted peace with Frankfurt, cool. How much money are we making now? 20.5, it's pretty close. Malacca declare war on Ayutthaya. Malacca declare war on Ayutthaya. Wow, Ayutthaya is getting wasted. You attack Langxiang and you are losing. Okay. That's interesting. Because usually Ayutthaya gets really big and blobs the crap out of this entire area. So that's... yeah, interesting. I think it's the correct term. Alliance of Austria. Yeah, we want to keep that. Stupid Ruska. You are not meant to be part of my glorious empire. You don't belong. Recruits flock to standards. Expired. Ethiopian. Wait, what? Why do we have a truce with Ethiopia? Oh, that's right, we had an alliance at one point. Cretan separatists have fired. Where? Oh! Hey, Athens? Yes, you will give him rights to go into your land. Good. That's annoying. They have 1-1. Good, you have 3 maneuver. 4. You, head down here. Athens? Thank you. Naxos has decided to allow us... Oh, that's not Athens, that's Naxos. I just saw the word Athens, I thought that was Athens, but no, it's not Athens. When it's Athens, not Athens! Oh, man. That's interesting. I thought they were going to fire here, but clearly they weren't. Who are the next separatists? Mamlukian. Sarahan. Sarahan, who are you? Over here. Trebizond. Up there, okay. Let's go send you to Sarahan. Which is what? Flatlands. Excellent. Awesome. Send you back across here, and I will cancel military access as soon as I can. Which is in a couple days. Cancel. And I believe I was improving with the city of Ruska so I could freaking integrate it. Rebel across the border. Oh, great. Why is there Crimean separatists here? They're gonna get that. I can't stop it. Darn. Okay, well, let's continue improving with city of Ruska. Oh, so now I have 3 vassals. Was it 2? No. Yeah, 3 vassals. Najd. Gain a core. Great. Yeah, they're going to get that. I wasn't expecting them to show up like that. Cossack aggression. Moving quickly by boat or on horseback, the Cossacks on the steppes are very adept raiders. Okay, so what's happening here? Several such raids have lately laid waste to our countryside and even major cities some way from our borders. Once the raid has been executed, these plunderers retreat back behind the borders of neighboring countries. So which country is it? Does it say? Both the empty techs and our empty techs have interest. Okay, so demand the Cossacks be brought to justice. Oh, Muscovite. Well, screw you, Muscovites. That's a good reason to go to war, but... I don't want to war you right now. Not when I have a huge coalition here already. Yeah. Damn it, Spain. I mean, Poland was one thing, but Spain was not meant to show up. That's the annoying part. Stupid Spain. Can't mind your own business. I'll be crossing a river here. Is that a problem? 011. I'm a 261. Effectively a 15. Yeah, I'll be fine. Yeah, it's better than the other general. It's not as bad as a straight crossing. Should be a nice... Wow, he rolled good. Okay, both rolled zeros on the shock fates, but doesn't matter. Nice easy fight. Medri Bari has accepted peace with Kaffa. Gained a call on Kizil Yar. Kizil Yar. I don't know. I'm probably horribly mispronouncing that as well. Karakunu has occupied Tind. Yay. Tind. Nice easy name. Mutually has left us. Which one? No, it's our 6th shock general. You'll be missed. You will definitely be missed. We don't need you to contribute warrior, so that basically means I don't have to support you, which is great. Race host in 55. We are still losing 4.86 ducats a month. No rebellions are about to happen right now, so I'm going to turn maintenance down to, say, half. Or, say, yep. A third. Ooh, I probably should be careful. Lithuanian troops around my border. That would not be good if they were to attack. Ohm accepted peace with Bavaria. Aw, Ohm lost. What a shame. Cologne has lost, given land to Mainz. Mainz, Cologne, Mainz. Mainz is around here, right? That's Munster. Mainz. Mainz is growing. Good job. Gain core on 10. Good. Unrest is getting there. Alodia. So a piece of Kaffa. Fine. We can take tech. 7 years early. Let's not. And with that, I think that'll be it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed this episode. I'll see you next time for more of This Is Persia. Until then, see you later.